In a previous video about the definition of a subspace, we learned that if you have a vector space, let's say it's called W, that is containing a larger vector space, let's say it's called V, then W is said to be a subspace of V. So the language I'm using, such as W is contained in V, and the diagram I'm drawing using those ellipses, those are trying to describe the idea of a subset. As we remember, vector spaces are sets to begin with. So every vector space is a set, but not every set is a vector space. For a set to be a vector space, it needs to be non-empty, and it needs to satisfy these 10 axioms that we went over in the definition of a vector space. Likewise, a vector space V may have many different subsets, but not all subsets of V are going to be subspaces of V. Only those subsets that are themselves vector spaces are subspaces of V. So every subspace of V is a subset of V to begin with, but not all subsets of V are subspaces of V. So if you are given a specific subset, let's still call it W, of V, how do you know if W is a subspace of V? If you directly use the definition, then you have to go through 10 axioms to verify whether W is a vector space. What I'm going to show you next is that you don't have to go through all 10 of them. You only need to go through 2 of them, which saves you a lot of time. So which 2 of those 10 axioms do you think are the ones that you actually need to verify? And which 8 do you think you can omit? The key to answering this question is to understand that once we know that these 10 axioms are true for a set V, which makes V a vector space, then 6 of these axioms are automatically true for all subsets of V, while the remaining 4, which are axioms 1, 4, 5, and 6, these 4 axioms are only true for subspaces of V. Let me explain the details. For any subset W of V, we want to replace the letter V with the letter W in these axioms. And verify that these axioms are still true. That is, we know they're true for V. We want to see if they're true for W. For those axioms that are not 1, 4, 5, 6, that is, those axioms not circled, you can see that they're true for W just because W is a subset of V. For example, if you have commutative law of addition for any two elements in V, then you're going to have commutative law of addition for any two elements in W, because any element in W is automatically an element in V. That's because W is a subset of V. If you're still trying to get used to the set theory logic that we're using here, think of this analogy. Let's say I have a set that contains these apples. There are different types of apples, like Golden Delicious, Fuji, or Granny Smith. But it's true that every element in the set is an apple. So if I'm taking any subset of this set, let's say I take this subset of these two apples, then it's true that every element of this subset is still an apple. It's the same logic we are using here to argue that these axioms 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10 are inherited by any subset of V. That is, if these axioms are true for V, then they are true for any subset of V. On the other hand, for the 4 axioms that are circled here, they're no longer automatically true just because W is a subset. For example, if we look at axiom 1, if we pick 2 elements in W, the sum of those 2 elements, even though they are still in V because V is closed under addition, they may not be in W. Let me give you a quick example of a subset W of R2 that is not closed under addition. Consider the set W containing the two elements 1, 0 and 0, 1. W is a subset of R2 because both elements in W are elements in R2. W is not closed under addition because the sum of the two elements 1, 0 and 0, 1, which is 1, 1, is not an element of W, which makes W not closed under addition. Likewise, for some subsets of V, you're going to find that it may not contain a zero element, which means axiom 4 is not true, and it may not make axioms 5 and 6 true. So that means to verify that a subset W of V is a subspace, what you really need to verify are these 4 circled axioms. So at this point, we have reduced the task of verifying 10 axioms to verifying only 4 axioms. We're going to further reduce that to verifying only two axioms, axiom 1 and axiom 6. The reason is that once we have verified axiom 6, then axioms 4 and 5 are guaranteed to be true. That is because axiom 6 says for any scalar C that is a real number and any element V in W, the scalar multiple C times V must be in W. So W is closed. Actually, this is W. W is closed under scalar multiplication. So if you verify that axiom 6 is true, which means this works for any scalar, then it should work for the scalar C equal to 0, which means the 0 vector should be in W. And it should also work for the scalar C equal to negative 1, which means negative of the element should be in W. So that means verifying axiom 6 first, we have also verified axioms 4 and 5 in the same time. So ultimately, the two axioms we need to verify are axiom 1, this is also W. W is closed under addition, and axiom 6, W is closed under scalar multiplication. So, as a summary, if you want to verify that a subset W of a vector space V is a subspace of V, you only need to do two things. Number one, verify W is closed under addition. Number two, verify W is closed under scalar multiplication for any real scalar. Once you verify these two things, then W must be a subspace of V.